The next topic is Gauss law. Generally, to find the electric field intensity due to continuous charge distribution, we can use the Gauss law. First of all, let us see what is meant by Gauss law. Here it is. The statement of Gauss law is, the total electric flux, the total electric flux passing a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times, 1 by epsilon naught times the net charge, 1 by epsilon naught times the net charge enclosed by the closed surface. Closed surface. This is the statement of the Gauss law. The total electric flux passing through a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the net charge enclosed by the closed surface. We can write mathematically phi is equal to q net epsilon naught. Phi is equal to q net by epsilon naught. This is a Gauss law. Now, how can we prove this Gauss law now? Once again, see the statement. The total electric flux passing through a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the net charge enclosed by the closed surface. Now, let's consider a positive charge Q is enclosed by a closed surface like this. The electric lines of force are always away from the positive charge. So, the electric flux or the electric lines of force are always away from the positive charge. So that the electric flux, which spreads in all directions, it can intersect this closed surface and will come out. Now, let us see how much flux can pass through a small elemental area. First of all, let us see how much flux is passing through a small elemental area. Here it is. So, consider a small area here like this. Consider small area here. This small area is taken as ds, and this area is taken at a distance of r. And this small area ds subtends a small solid angle d omega. This small area subtending small solid angle d omega at the position of the charge q. Now, this ds area is represented by a area vector. This is taken as ds bar. Ds bar is the area vector drawn normal to the surface, and the direction of electric field is taken here in this direction. This is taken as E bar, and the angle between both of them is taken as theta. E bar is the electric field vector and ds bar is the area vector, and both are making an angle theta with each other. Now, how much flux is passing through this small area now? Flux passing through the small elemental area ds is given by d phi is equal to e bar dot ds bar. D phi is equal to E bar dot ds bar. Now, you can write this one as EDS into cos theta. EDS into cos theta. Now, the flux through the total area is taken as integral d phi. Here, this surface is the closed surface. So, I am writing this is closed integral d phi. That is equal to closed integral EDS into cos theta. Therefore, you can write phi is equal to E integral ds into cos theta. E into integral ds into cos theta. Now, what is meant by E? Here it is. Here, E is the electric field intensity at this point, that is at a distance r, due to this positive charge, where electric field E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square. Here E is the electric field intensity at this point due to the positive charge q at a distance r is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square. Now we can substitute this value in this equation. Therefore, you can write phi is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square integral ds into cos theta. Ds into cos theta. Now, rewriting this equation as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q into closed integral ds into cos theta by r square. Ds cos theta by r square. That is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught into closed integral ds cos theta by r square is nothing but this area subtending an angle d omega at a distance r is called as a solid angle. Here, this small area ds subtending a small solid angle d omega. So, you can write q by 4 pi epsilon naught into integral of d omega, where d omega is equal to what? Ds into cos theta by r square, the small solid angle. The solid angle subtended by small area ds at the position of q is nothing but ds cos theta by r square. Now, integral of d omega, that is the total solid angle subtended by the closed surface area, that can be taken as q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 4 pi into 4 pi. Since closed integral d omega equal to 4 pi, the total solid angle subtended by the total area is equal to 4 pi radians. Therefore, we can write q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 4 pi. Here 4 pi cancelled. Now you can write phi is equal to q by epsilon naught. Phi is equal to q by epsilon naught. So this is the mathematical form of Gauss law. Once again, see the total electric flux passing through a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the net charge enclosed by this closed surface. Phi is equal to q net by epsilon naught. Here I am taking the total charge as q, and this q is enclosed by a closed surface of area s. First of all, let us see a small area ds. How much flux is passing through this small area ds? That is calculated by taking d phi is equal to E ds into cos theta. By integrating this, you can calculate
the flux passing through the entire area or the total closed surface area. So integral of d pi is equal to integral of EDS into cos theta. Pi is equal to E integral ds into cos theta. But we know E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon to E by r square, substituting everything like this. And here ds cos theta by r square is equal to d omega. Integral d omega is equal to 4 pi. Then you can get phi is equal to q by epsilon naught. This is about Gauss law and its proof law. Have a look.